Welcome to Box Recaps. Today I'm going to explain the movie Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, released in the year 2005. The movie starts and we see a young boy named Charlie Bucket, who lives with his poor family in a crooked house. Charlie is sitting with his grandpa, and the old man goes on to tell him a story about the times when he used to work at the chocolate factory for his boss named Willy Wonka. Wonka was a genius confectioner whose candies were so profitable that demand shot through the roof. And in no time, he graduated from running a single corner store to building a massive factory 50 times the size of any others out there. Wonka's success didn't come without its downfalls. For one, he had to deal with eccentric clients, such as an Indian prince who commissioned Wonka to build him a palace made entirely out of chocolate, which then melted under the heat of a sunny day. At home, Wonka found himself dealing with industrial espionage, as competing candy manufacturers, envious of Wonka's success, began sending spies in to steal his trade secrets. Wonka then got frustrated and just decided to shut down the factory. It is revealed by the grandpa that recently, the chocolate factory has started producing chocolate again, but no one knows who's running the factory, and Willy Wonka has not shown himself to the public yet. The next day, we see motorcycle riders from Wonka's factory distributing flyers all over town. Wonka has decided to hold a contest to invite 5 lucky children to see the inner workings of his factory. The 5 winners will be those who find the golden tickets, which he's personally inserted into 5 Wonka chocolate bars around the world. Wonka has also mentioned that one of these 5 children is going to receive a very special gift from Wonka himself as well. After this announcement, the people in all over the world start going crazy for his chocolate bars. Charlie's birthday arrives, and his family decides to give him a Wonka chocolate on his birthday. They all hope that they will be able to find the golden ticket in the chocolate, and they could win the prize and make their financial condition better. Time goes by, and we learn that 4 golden tickets have already been found. The first ticket is found by Augustus Gloop of Dusseldorf, Germany, who is a fat kid and happens to eat many chocolate bars a day. His mother is really happy and even goes on to praise her son for being so gluttonous. On the other hand, the second ticket is won by Veruca Salt, and she is a spoiled daughter of a wealthy English family. It is revealed that her rich father had bought countless Wonka bars for her as he wanted to find a golden ticket for his daughter at any cost, and he made the people at his own factory open all these mini bars, and they are the ones who find the ticket. The third ticket, in the meantime, is found by Violet Beauregard of Atlanta. This girl wants to be the best at everything, and her drive to be the best leads her to believe that she is sure to win Wonka's special prize, seeing it as a competition. The fourth ticket is found by Mike TV of Denver, Colorado, a video game-obsessed young boy. This boy actually hates chocolate, but he badly wanted to get his hands on the golden ticket, so he has used the scientific theory and process of elimination to find himself a ticket. In the meantime, Charlie's family brings him a Wonka bar, and he opens it, hoping that there's going to be a golden ticket in there. But when he opens it, he's disappointed, as there is no ticket in there. He then goes on to share the chocolate with his whole family, and they all enjoy the Wonka bar. In the meantime, we see that the demand for chocolate has been rising in the whole world ever since Wonka Factory has made the announcement about 5 golden tickets. The upswing in candy sales has caused a rise in toothpaste sales, leading to the factory to automate their assembly line, replacing Charlie's father with an automated robot that does his job in half the time. This is how Charlie's father has also lost his job. Mr. Bucket, however, decides not to tell this to his family, but Charlie can very much sense that his father is worried. That day, Charlie's grandpa goes on to give him some money. He tells Charlie to go buy another Wonka bar for him and try his luck for the golden ticket once more. Charlie makes his way out and buys another chocolate. When he opens it with his grandfather, he is again disappointed because there is no golden ticket in there. Charlie is outside when he overhears a man saying all the 5 golden tickets have been found, and Charlie is heartbroken to learn that because he really wanted to get his hands on one of the tickets. Charlie finds some money in the snow and goes to a shop where he overhears a woman talking, and he learns that the 5th ticket holder was actually a scammer and there's still one golden ticket left. He uses the money to buy a Wonka bar, and when he opens it, he is not able to believe his eyes because in front of him is the golden ticket. He does not know how to contain his excitement, and the other people in the store gather around him, and some of them go on to offer him a lot of money for the golden ticket. The shop owner, however, is a good man, and he tells Charlie to get out of the job because he does not want anyone to snatch the ticket from the little boy. Charlie makes his way home, and he makes the announcement to his family. His grandpa is so excited that he starts dancing with the ticket in his hand. He then tells his son to read what's written on the ticket, and Mr. Bucket reads that the factory has told the winner of the golden ticket to bring one elder member of the family when they come to visit the factory. His grandpa wishes to be Charlie's paternal guardian for the tour, which is happening the next day. Charlie is at first against this, given he feels he could sell the ticket and get money for things the family needs. However, his old man convinces Charlie that he has something very valuable and shouldn't give it up for them. The next day, all the five kids make their way to the factory with their family members. They then go inside the factory, and the huge gate of the factory closes behind them. They're welcomed by dolls, and a song on Willy Wonka is also played. After that, Wonka himself appears from the side and gives them an orientation speech. He then leads them all into his factory, inviting them into a room he calls the Chocolate Room. It is essentially an edible forest, where Wonka encourages his guests to enjoy themselves. He goes on to tell them that everything in that room has been made of chocolate. There's a little waterfall, the grass, the other stuff, all of it is made of chocolate. Veruca spots some little people nearby doing labor, getting the attention of everyone else. Wonka explains that these are his workers, the Oompa Loompas. Wonka goes on to tell the kids that these little people have come from a place called Loompa Land, where they lived in constant fear of being eaten by various wild creatures. Wonka stumbled upon them while wandering into their forest, trying to find new exotic flavors for his candies. He was disgusted by their diet of mashed-up caterpillars, but found something in common with their leader when he found out that their culture revered the cocoa bean, the root ingredient to the production of chocolate. This allowed him to make a deal where he convinced the Oompa Loompas to come work for him in the factory in exchange for getting all the cocoa beans he needs for his factory. Everything is going smoothly until the gluttonous fat kid, Augustus, begins trying to drink chocolate directly from the chocolate river that runs through the room. Wonka tries to get him to stop, but Augustus doesn't listen and falls in. He's then drawn into and sucked up a pipe that extracts chocolate to the section of the factory where Wonka's fudge is made. Due to his girth, he gets stuck in the pipe, causing a blockage. As the tour group stands there, bewildered and concerned, the Oompa Loompas gather around the pipe and go on to sing a song. The girl's father thinks that all of it was planned. On the other hand, Augustus's mother is really worried for her son, who is now stuck inside a pipe. Augustus tries to get out of the pipe, but he's not able to do it because of his girth. He ends up falling in the fudge room. The little men then lead his mother to the fudge room so that she brings her son back. When the mother leaves, the sound of deep drums reveals a huge pink Viking boat with several dozen Oompa Loompas rowing. The group boards the boat, which takes them down the river and leads them into some darkened tunnels, leading to other parts of the factory. As they sit on the boat, Wonka goes on to give some chocolate to Charlie, and Charlie asks him a question. He asks him when was the first time Wonka ate a chocolate, and the scene goes into flashback, and Wonka reveals that his dad was the most famous dentist in their city, and he was against eating candy. He reveals that he had a strained relationship with his father, who forbade young Willy from ever eating candy, and would regularly throw away any candy he got for Halloween. As he tells the story, they pass through many weird rooms, and then they finally get to Willy Wonka's favorite room, which he calls the Inventing Room. Wonka explains that this is where a lot of his candy formulas are tested before being released to the public. Among his new products he's testing out are Everlasting Gobstoppers, and a product called Hair Toffee that's supposed to reverse hair loss, but is still not quite yet ready, since the Oompa Loompa who's tested it has instead grown out a huge carpet of hair, covering his entire body. Wonka goes on to tell the group that this bubblegum has three flavors, and it is going to be delicious. Young Violet wants to chew this thing so badly because it sounds delicious, but Wonka tells her not to make that mistake. Violet, however, does not listen to him and goes on to chew the chocolate anyway. After a while, her skin begins having a negative reaction. Her skin begins to turn purple in color, and then she swells up into a giant 10-foot blueberry. Some Oompa Loompas emerge and perform a Michael Jackson-style dance number as they roll her back to the boat and take her and her mother to another room to squeeze the juice out of her so that she's able to get back to her normal size. Willy then tells the rest of the group to get a move on, as they still have a lot to see. The three kids left in the group are now Charlie, Mike, and Veruca. They then make their way to a room Wonka calls the Nut Room. The kids see that there are a lot of squirrels in that room, and Wonka tells the kids these little creatures actually work for him, and they are highly trained. The kids then see the squirrels working on walnuts. They're tasked with selecting the right nuts and rejecting the bad ones. When Veruca sees these squirrels, she goes on to tell her rich father that she wants one of these squirrels, but Wonka tells her that she cannot have it. Veruca, however, does not listen to him, despite him telling her again and again that these little things are not for sale. Veruca is a stubborn child. She still goes downstairs to catch a squirrel, and when she is right between them, the squirrels think that she too is a nut, and they all climb her body and start checking, when one of the squirrels declares that she is a bad nut. The little girl is then tossed down the garbage chute in the center of the room. Wonka goes on to tell Veruca's father that he can retrieve his daughter. Wonka's men again show up and sing a song about how this little girl is a brat because her father has been granting her everything she has ever wished for. Wonka then takes the rest of the group, including Mike and Charlie, with their guardians to an elevator. The elevator leads the group through many rooms. It passes through the Fudge Mountain. Then they go to a room where Oompa Loompas shear the wool off pink sheep for cotton candy. They also go to the Puppet Hospital and Burn Center, which has been built recently. And finally, they go to a room where candies are being tested for use in warfare. Charlie again asks Wonka how he started all this, and the scene goes into flashback, and Wonka reveals that his father never allowed him to have candy, but he was a candy lover, so he got sick of trying to win his mean father's approval and just left his house to live his life around chocolate. Wonka then tells Mike to press a button, and they go to the TV room, where Wonka has developed some rather unusual technology. Namely, a machine that transmits an enormous bar of chocolate to a nearby TV and shrinks it down to normal size, and is then taken by Charlie. Wonka proclaims this method could revolutionize television commercials, but Mike is incensed that Wonka has developed a teleporter, and he does not even realize what he's done. Mike turns on the machine, and he ends up getting sucked into the TV, and his size decreases to that of a mouse. They get him out, but his size is still the same. Wonka's men again show up and sing a song. Mike's father asks him how his son is going to get back to normal, and Wonka tells his men to take Mike to the stretch room. And just like that, Charlie is the only kid left. They then get on an elevator, and Wonka presses an up and down button. They go up and see the other four kids leave the factory in a bad condition. With the other kids gone, Charlie is announced to be the winner. Wonka then presses another button and takes the elevator right into the small house of Charlie. He lands there, and the family is shocked to see them. Wonka tells Charlie that his special prize is to be the new owner of this factory, because Wonka himself is getting old now. Wonka, however, says that Charlie is going to have to leave his family, which Charlie declines, saying his family is the most important thing to him. Wonka gets upset and leaves. Charlie's father, in the meantime, gets his old job back because Wonka is distressed and the candy sales have gone down, which has led the toothpaste sale to go down as well. Wonka eventually turns to Charlie for advice, and he decides to help Wonka reconcile with his estranged father, Wilbur. During the reunion, Charlie then goes on to notice the newspaper clippings of Wonka's success, which Wilbur collected, while Wonka realizes the value of family as he and Wilbur finally reconcile. Afterwards, Wonka allows Charlie and his family to move into the factory together. And with that, the movie comes to an end. Subscribe for more videos like this. Turn on the notification and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.